Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net, and welcome to the third in our series of videos on troubleshooting problems with your outboard ignition system. In our first video, we took you through the components of the ignition system, and then in our second, we showed you how to test the spark plugs. So if you need to see those, we have a link in the description below so you can go check them out. But in this video, we're going to take a look at some of the other parts of the ignition system, like fuses, switches, ignition coils, and your stator and regulator rectifier. So if you're ready, I'll walk you through and show you what you need to look at. So let's go. Okay guys, let's start with the simple stuff first. You don't want to go plunging into everything to find out that the problem was the fuse. So let's check that first. If your outboard has a fuse on the ignition system, start there. Pull it and take a look to see if the filament is burned out, because replacing a bad fuse is a really easy fix that can get you up and running again quickly. The next easy fix you may want to check is the tilt kill switch. Now your outboard may or may not have this, but what it does, it will kill the motor if it's raised up too high. Like if you hit something and it kicked the motor up, or if it's not down in the water enough to pick up the water for cooling. So to find it, you're gonna look on the tilt trim assembly or the mounting bracket. Now to test it, get a multimeter and set it to low ohm test, and then connect the two wires coming from the switch. Now hold the switch horizontally like it would be in the motor if it were trimmed down, and then you should not see any current running through the switch. Now hold it at an angle like the switch would be if it were tilted up, and you should see something flowing through the switch. Now if you see an open or closed when it shouldn't be, you'll know that you'll need to go ahead and replace that switch. Now some units are going to have a kill switch, others will have just a trim limit switch or a trim sensor switch. This particular one has a sensor switch, but if your kill switch was actually being used, it would be in this general same location, but you just want to hook up your leads to your voltmeter to it and just see if either it goes through a variance, like this one goes from 4 ohms up to 232. So that tells me that this particular sensor is working. Now switch is either going to be opened or closed, so it would either be close to 0 ohms or infinity, which would represent, you know, an on or an off. But this is typically where you're going to find it on just about every outboard if it's equipped with it. Now the other switch you're going to want to check, and this will only apply to smaller outboards, is the one at the end of the tiller handle. It will have a wire running to your CDI, and that's basically a ground. For this test, get your multimeter, set it to ohms, and then touch the negative side to a ground and the positive to the wire coming to the CDI. Now if you're seeing continuity here, the switch has failed and you need to get a new one. Now to double check this, activate the switch or remove the lanyard to see if you get a low reading. If you don't, then again, you're going to need to replace it. Okay, so you've made it this far. Next, you want to check the plug wires. Now in another video, we showed you how to make sure the plugs were okay and getting current. But you want to do a closer inspection here on the wires. And if they've got any sorts of damage on the insulation, that can short out against the engine casing or anything else and really inhibit the current. You also want to check for corrosion around the boots and at the end of the plug wires where they connect to the plugs. That can cut out your power. Now here's a little test you can do to see if the wires are damaged. Connect your multimeter to each end of the plug wire itself, set it to ohms, and then hold the wire taut and straight. Your meter should read 0 or close to 0 ohms. Now, with the multimeter still attached, bend the wires and see if the reading changes. If it does, that could mean that the wires inside are failing and you should replace it. On this particular Yamaha unit, the wires are actually permanently affixed to your coil, but we can still check the wires in the same fashion by setting our meter to ohms and then bending the wires to see if it changes. Now you would do this a little bit differently if you were able to just remove it from the actual coil, you would just go end to end. Now on this particular one, we have to go through the secondary coil, the high tension coil. If you're good so far, you want to check out the ignition coils next. there are two coils. You have the primary and the secondary, and we want to test both of them. And to do that, we're kind of going to be doing what we did with the ignition wires. So here, let's start with the primary. And that's going to mean disconnecting the positive and negative terminals so there's no power running through the coils. And what you're going to do is set your multimeter to ohms again and connect the positive and negative terminals. Now, a service manual is going to tell you the resistance you're going to need to see on this test. And if you're not getting that, then the coil should be replaced. Now, to test the secondary coil, you'll want to connect one end of the multimeter to the negative terminal and the other side to the spark plug that comes in, and check the reading to see if it matches the specs from the manufacturer. Next, you're going to want to check the stator. Now, to do this, you're going to need to know what the resistance range is for your particular stator, and you can get that from your service manual as well. Now, set your multimeter for that resistance range and see if you get a pass. A low reading will probably mean you have a short in the windings, and if the reading is infinite, then you have a break somewhere in there and you need to replace the stator in either case. Now, next up is the regulator rectifier. Now, when it's working right, it only allows current to pass one direction, and that's a good way to tell if it's working or not. Now, there are two wires going in, the positive and the ground, and you want to disconnect those as well as the three wires that are going to the stator, providing, of course, that it is a three-phase setup. Now, you'll want to set your multimeter to the diode test and then connect the positive side of the multimeter to the negative terminal on the regulator rectifier, and then connect the negative side of the multimeter to each of the three connections coming out of the regulator rectifier to the stator. You should get a positive forward reading in volts, probably around the 0.5 area, telling you that the current is actually passing through the diodes as it should. Now, if any of these three tests fail, you're going to need to replace the unit. Then you want to retest it in the opposite direction to make sure current is not flowing backwards. This time, connect the positive probe of your multimeter to the positive terminal of the regulator rectifier, and then the negative on the multimeter to each of those three conductors coming from the stator. You should see an open loop, which tells you that no current is traveling backwards. Now, of course, if you get a reading that there is current going through, well, once again, you're going to need to replace it. Now, earlier, we talked about the kill switch on the tiller handle for smaller outboards, but on a bigger unit, you're going to want to check the turn key switch itself. Now, to get to the back of it, you may need to remove it, but here, you're going to set your multimeter to ohms once again, connect the positive side of the multimeter to the shutoff terminal wire, and then the negative to a negative ground source. Now, turn the switch on. If you get an open circuit with the switch in the on position, the switch has gone bad. Well, all right, guys, there you go. Just a few things on a checklist that you can take a look at if your outboard won't start. Well, listen, if you need parts for your boat, why don't you come see us at boats.net and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.